question comes from where? London, UK. The hadith about reading Surah Al-Kahf every Friday. As we said last night, ثَبِّتْ عَرْشَكْ ثُمَّنْ خُشْ. Solidify your throne, then decorate your throne. Sheikh Yahya al-Hajuri, he has a book called أحكام الجمعة وبدعها. He has a book on the regulations of Jumu'ah and its innovations. It's a book that I purchased some years ago in Yemen and also in Medina. And in that book, he has a very interesting chapter on reading Surah Al-Kahf on Fridays. And the Sheikh, his opinion is that the hadith regarding reading Surah Al-Kahf every Friday is weak, is inauthentic. Now, we've explained this before on Mufti Q&A. I've given you what I thought, my opinion, which is the same. I don't think it's authentic. But it's a very important point that he mentioned that I didn't see anyone else mention. Of the scholars who talk about it, I haven't seen anyone else mention this point that he mentioned. And he said that from the things that prove that the hadith is da'if and it's not authentic is that there are no narrations stating that the Salaf al-Salih did it. There aren't any athar that the Salaf would do it on Friday. He says, I read the Sunnah al-Kubra, Bayhaqi, Tafsir ibn Jarir, all right, Musannaf ibn Abi Shayba, Musannaf Abdul Razak, Mudan al-Athar, al-Munqufa. He says the places where the athar, the statements of the Sahaba and the Salaf are collected, he says you can't find any of them stating Ata, Hassan Basri, Saeed Jubair, Fulan, this one, that one, read Surah Al-Kahf on Fridays. He says, so that proves what the hadith research also proves, it supports it, is that it's weak and it's ghayr ma'roof, it's unknown to the Salaf al-Salih. So the correct view, as we've explained before, as some researchers, as is another researcher, Sheikh Abdullah Al-Fawzan, he has a book on it as well, on the hadith, and he concludes in his research paper, his book, is that the hadith لا يصح مرفوعا ولا منخوفا. It's not authentic from the Prophet nor from the companion. So that's the correct view, is that it is not authentic. However, if you believe that it's authentic, or if you follow this alim or this scholar or Sheikh Al-Albani or this one or that one, then that's fine. There's nothing wrong with that. You stick with what you know, stick with who you trust. But if you ask me, I can only tell you what I believe in my heart. Everyone understand this? Yani, and a person who reads Surah Al-Kahf every single Friday, yani, they believe that it's authentic, inshallah, that's khair. I had a teacher in the Islam University of Medina, Sheikh Abdul Qayyum al-Suhaibani, in the College of Hadith. He was going over the hadith about sitting in the masjid after Salat al-Fajr and making dhikr of Allah and leaving the masjid after the sun has risen, as it is a reward of Hajj and Umrah. Naam. And he said, he was coming down some of the students of knowledge. He was criticizing us. He was saying, some of you guys have no fiqh. He says, you go and you tell the general people that the hadith is da'if, it's weak. He said, it's not hikmah for the general people to sit in the masjid after Fajr and remain in Allah's house and them not knowing that it's weak is best for them. Which makes sense to an extent. But at the same time, does that mean that we keep people upon weak and da'if stuff and have them performing spirituality upon something which is what? Inauthentic. That's the problem. That's the doorway to what? To bid'ah. Let the people be religious and spiritual, even if it's not authentic. I'm not criticizing my teacher. I'm trying to make a point here. I'm trying to make a what? A point here. So if someone reads Surah Al-Kahf based off of what they read, that's best for them. But if you wish to know the truth and the correct and strong view, then that's what it is, that the hadith is not what? Authentic. As far as those who hold the view that it is authentic and they wish to read it every Friday, then obviously the narrations of Surah Al-Kahf are known, the hadith in Sahih Muslim about the Dajjal, reading the first ayat of Surah Al-Kahf upon the Dajjal, okay, the creation of the heavens and the earth, the Tawheed, Hijra, Naam, Musa and Khidr, Iblis and Adam, many important stories of Surah Al-Kahf, huh? Friday being the day of Qiyamah, etc. Now, this is from the wisdoms of reading it based off of that hadith. And Allah knows best.